day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, we're going to keep this short and sweet. We're going to learn about beveled text. When you bring out this basic text object, type something that you want. I'm going to do HLModTech because that's who I am. And then the question was, how do you add a bevel to text? Friends, it's this easy. If you put a 1 right here and you put a 10 right here, or you can see they defaulted to a 3, it does sweet beveled text. As you play with these numbers and adjust them, it does make them change. For instance, if you do 1.5, notice I'm going to type this number. It has more of a bevel. It also pushes out, but you can have so much fun just adjusting these fonts. Now we do only have 4 available. I'm going to do Control D and Shift Nudge to move it up. The 4 that we have are the multi-language Sans, which you can see has smoother corners. I'll do Control D again. Notice because I haven't touched anything, it has memorized that move. I love that technique. There is Sans Mono, and then once again, we'll do Control D one more time. And the 4th one we can choose is Serif. Now, as you're playing with this, these numbers, you can slide them, adjust them, whatever you want. One cool thing is if you go all the way back to 1, then you get a sweet chiseled end. So you can have fun exploring just how cool you can make your beveled text. Now, while I'm out here, friends, I do want to remind you about search. If you type script, there is a second awesome font. Notice I have clicked the star, so it's a favorite. I'll show you where those are in a minute. These do look really cool, so notice I'll put my HLModTech again. But these do not have the options. All you can change is the height. You cannot bevel these fancier fonts. You do have several to pick from. Once again, you just click to switch between them, but these do not have that ability. As I wrap up, don't forget, if you did make something a favorite, you can click right here and go to your favorites to find all of them. I do also want to remind you, if you ever make something awesome that you always want to use, like say I want a blue HLModTech saved as a logo, I can also switch to your creations and I can create the shape HLModTech. And then I never want to lock the part size. I could add a description and tags, but I'm going to just hit save. And from then on, it will be available for me to just drag out and use in any project. Friends, I hope you found this quick tutorial useful. And I also want to send a huge shout out to Rajpoon Shabda. It absolutely makes my day when I'm creating content that I know users want. Friends, as I wrap up, let me remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with a ton of awesome categories, and then right below it, the first day lessons. These are great for anybody that's just starting out in Tinkercad. Friends, I also want to highlight the super cool built-in messaging. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are more than 600 members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.